Is there a change on the way within government? Interesting interview with the Sunday Telegraph yesterday. Liz Truss talking about the possibility that the HS2 rail link could be scrapped. Now, she's seen as a possible future Conservative leader, possibly even, of course, therefore, Prime Minister. She talked about examining all major investment projects across government, judging their contribution to future prosperity. These are her words, by the way. In reviewing this evidence, we must be prepared to junk the white elephants, the programmes that haven't worked, and roll back mission creep, where government involves itself in areas the private sector can deliver. Not sure about that aspect. Let's put this to Joe Rukin as campaign manager for Stop HS2. How did you interpret Liz Truss's words? Morning to you.
Well, it's very odd that it seems to be a prerequisite for anyone who's tipped for Tory leader to be saying that they're looking at scrapping HS2, whether it's Liz Truss or before her Gove or Boris Johnson. But if anyone was to look at HS2 in the cold light of day and assess it in terms of its impact on the economy, it'd never have got this far in the first place. So it's heartening. But the other thing is that we do know that they're expected to be producing the latest fiddle of the business case at some point in the next couple of months, which of course will invent a stack load of more benefits, which some will say, oh well, there you go, there's the evidence how brilliant it's going to be for the economy, without probably looking at the increase in costs.
You don't see the mood music changing, Mr. Rukin, clearly.
Oh no. We've got to be optimistic that, you know, Liz Truss, again, like all the other people have been touted for Tory leader,
Well, she's, of course, Treasury Minister. You know, she's in quite a key point, post here, I should say.
Well, Philip Hammond's always been reasonably for it, but the Treasury internally, the civil servants in the Treasury, have never been great fans of HS2. And if you ever look at HS2 in the cold light today and actually assess the figures, it is a financial...
Oh, it's absurd. It's absolutely absurd.
It has been from start to finish.
Yeah.
And the key thing maybe to look at is that there's lots of news coming out of HS2 that, you know, that they're looking to cut costs, say, with the route around Cheshire, which is impossible with the route they've chosen. They're looking to cut costs here. They're looking to cut costs there. The chief executive is in complete denial, saying, you know, it's not over budget. We've got a cost gap. Not that it's over budget.
A cost gap. So it's gone from 56 billion. Some are suggesting it may be nearer to 100 billion. Joe Rukin, good speaking. We'll talk again, but I must leave it there for time reasons. Your campaigns manager for Stop HS2.